Welcome back to Vision Miner 3D Printing News. Today we're talking about golf putters, rockets, submarines, the US Army, and of course, Lamborghini. I know, it just comes up all the time. Anyway, let's jump right into it. Starting off today, we've got Bluesint. Materialise is now able to recycle 100% of their sintering powder for SLS 3D printing. For those in the know, this is pretty gnarly. 3D printing is often better and more economical and even more green than traditional methods, but it does still produce waste. In the case of powder bed fusion, or SLS, there's actually a lot of waste. Specifically, in PBF, or SLS, a laser sinters powder, turning it into a part. Now, the unsintered powder remains behind and supports the rest of the part as it builds up, you know, sort of like overhangs and whatnot and other processes. Now, when a block of powder that's been printed is taken out, the parts are then cleaned, the powder's removed, it's sieved, and then recycled. So the problem is this can't really be done indefinitely because as the powder continually gets reused, it actually degrades and the part properties end up suffering. So the utilization and recycling rates kind of vary depending on the materials and the parts and the geometries and then the different colors and additives and things like that in the material. But generally, they throw away about half of all the sintering powder that goes into the machine. And most of this right now is nylon 12. So globally, hundreds of millions of dollars of powder are literally thrown away every year. With the Bluesint process, they tweaked a dual laser powder bed system to heat the recycled powder before building it into new parts. The company claims that with this process, they can achieve 100% recycling rate. Now, this is gonna save Materialise themselves millions of dollars a year in powder because they can now repurpose it all into parts. Now, if the company somehow shares this technology with others, it'll be a huge boost for other services, but if they keep it to themselves, well, I mean, it'll be a big advantage. Sharing is caring, guys. Let's get this out there. They described their recent innovation by saying, using a 3D printer with multiple lasers, Materialise engineers were able to use one laser for sintering powder and a second laser to keep the powder above a certain temperature. By preventing the powder from cooling down between two layers, they prevented the shrinking process that causes the orange peel effect. The result is a printed object with very similar mechanical and visual properties, but printed with 100% recycled powder, drastically reducing waste. They also say that over the course of 2021, Materialise plans to have several laser sintering machines running Bluesint PA12. In the startup phase alone, the company aims to reuse more than 5 tons of powder that would normally become waste. This is awesome. Moving right along, we've got a new golf putter that is anything but subpar. Oh my God. So Cobra, the big golf manufacturing company, uses HP Metal Jet to 3D print some next gen putters. It has a first of its kind 3D printing golf putter. The King Supersport 35 3DP has just been commercially launched by Cobra Golf, a leading golf equipment manufacturer which developed this latest innovation in golf equipment in partnership with HP and Parmatech. So Cobra Golf has a long history of innovation in golf equipment, known for its introduction of hybrid material clubs and the baffler and lighter clubs that feature graphite shafts and oversized irons, among other products. Now Cobra began working with HP and Parmatech over the last 2 years, and the King Supersport 35 3DP putter is just the first of several revolutionary commercial Cobra products using 3D printing. This new club has been optimized for weight distribution and moment of inertia, or MOI, which is a measure of how much a club head resists twisting on off-center strikes of the ball, and to ensure consistency, reliability, and accuracy in every putt. To develop the design, engineers and designers over at Cobra, who are also avid golfers, began working in early 2019 with their counterparts at HP and Parmatech. By early 2020, they had 35 design iterations, and they'd been created over that 8-month period. In addition, the design also features a high-performance aluminum face insert that uses patented descending loft technology from the SIK Golf, a putting manufacturer, to create a more consistent launch conditions on strikes across the face. As per Cobra. We've actually seen some really cool stuff with golf clubs from some different golf companies here in the shop. It's very, very interesting stuff. Next, moving right along, we've got a $9.5 billion submarine contract with 3D printing. Early in November 2020, the US Navy actually awarded the General Dynamics Electric Boat Division a $9.5 billion contract. That's B, a billion, $9.5 billion to build two first-in-class Columbia-class submarines. The Columbia program needs to be fast-tracked due to the U.S. imperative to remain competitive with China's large Navy investments, and so working closely with the Navy. At the end of the 2019 business year, Electric Boat has disclosed the ongoing 3D printing accomplishments, including the first six 3D printed components. Now, one of the six components that are being 3D printed is an instrumentation bracket. The strong relationship came about because of the strong connection between the Navy and Electric Boat's additive manufacturing team. So at first, the AM team proposed non-critical parts for approval, and with the success of those prototypes, the AM team has been able to design components that could never be manufactured or machined traditionally at a fraction of the time and cost. In addition, ever since they started using 3D printing at Electric Boat, it's become a tool for supporting all sorts of products at multiple shipyards. So the team worked with engineers to design a fixture for lifting pad eyes, making it much easier and faster to complete the task and limiting the risks of possible rework. You know, it can be really hard to set up all these big welding fixtures and everything, so 3D printing comes right into play. So, as a quick note, if you're doing 3D printing or if you're thinking about doing 3D printing, there's a huge amount of R&D tax credits from the government for companies that make less than $50 million in revenue, and startups can get up to $250,000 per year in payroll tax cash rebates. So if you're thinking about getting into 3D printing or you're already doing it, there's other things like Section 127 and other stuff. So give us a call and we'll help you out. You could literally end up with a free printer at the end of the year. Just in tax savings. Moving right along, we've got Senvol's machine learning software being applied by the U.S. Army Research Lab for 3D printing missile parts. That's right, the U.S. Army Research Laboratory, or ARL, has awarded a contract to Senvol that will see its machine learning software used to help design and qualify 3D printed missile parts. As a part of the program, Senvol is set to leverage its machine learning algorithms to develop a flexible qualification plan that can be applied to any 3D printing method, component, or machine. According to Annie Wang, president over at Senvol, deploying the firm's ML technology will enable the Army to reduce its part lead times and costs while increasing soldier survivability. Although Senvol's software has been deployed in industries ranging from automotive to the medical sector, it has been particularly effective within military applications. For instance, the U.S. Navy's Office of Naval Research, or ONR, has utilized the ML program to reduce the lead times associated with seafaring components. Recently, the U.S. Air Force has also partnered with Senvol to develop a baseline mechanical properties for its powder bed fusion EOS 3D printers. Now, the project's eventual goal is to fabricate a missile part specifically, and compare its performance during testing to simulations provided by Senvol's ML software. If successful, these evaluations would not only validate the component in question, but also Senvol's technology for certifying other military devices as fit for purpose. You gotta love that military stuff. So, if you're liking this video, by the way, hit that like button down below or share the link with a friend as it helps them find something cool, helps us know that you like our stuff and want us to keep doing it. We are human, but the robotic AI algorithm of YouTube is really the reason I'm telling you to do this. It helps us out a lot and helps other people see these videos. Anyway, moving right along, we got Relativity Space raising $500 million. The California 3D printed rocket manufacturer Relativity Space is in the process of raising $500 million in Series D funding. So this new investment will reportedly be led by new contributors Tiger Global and Fidelity, and supported by long-standing investors Social Capital, Playground Global, Y Combinator, Bond Capital, and Tribe Capital. Following the funding round, which will take Relativity's new total cash raise to $685 million, the company's value is expected to rise to $2.3 billion. The aerospace firm is raising additional funds despite having yet to successfully fire its 3D printed Terran 1 rocket into orbit, although it's currently slated for a commercial launch in 2021. So, Relativity's fully fabricated launch vehicle, which it will manufacture in-house while using its Stargate 3D printer, has been in development since 2015, but it has gone on to reach several key milestones. The vessel's 14-foot fuel tank was first produced in 2017, and its Aeon 3D printed engine has been hot fire tested more than 200 times. Over the last 2 years, the company has also utilized the cash that it raised in previous funding rounds to build on its facilities and target a lead time of 60 days for each complete rocket. In June of 2019, Relativity was granted permission to build a 220,000 square foot autonomous rocket building factory at NASA's Stennis Space Center. Earlier this year, Relativity also moved to a new HQ in Long Beach, California, that has become the center of its business operations, as well as its Terran 1 production line. Guys, if you want to come up and shoot a video on that, I would love to do it. Hopefully this video gets to them. If you know anybody there, please share the link with the time code. Inside the 120,000 square foot site, 300 Relativity staff are working to accelerate their additive rockets development, and this has been rewarded with several high-profile contracts. Satellite producers Iridium Communications and Telesat have both contracted Relativity's rocket to fire their small satellites into lower Earth orbit. Next, moving right along, we got more crazy stuff with Lamborghini and the Huracán STO featuring 3D printed aerodynamics key. Yes, that's right. It's a key. It's a 3D printed key. So, you know, we're always looking. Whenever a new Lambo is launched, we scramble to find out which parts of it are 3D printed. And thanks to the deal they made with Carbon recently, it's actually quite a few. A huge thing is that the Bugatti CEO, Stefan Winkelmann, who's a huge supporter of metal additive manufacturing, is now taking over the president role at Lamborghini. And considering they're both owned by Volkswagen, that makes a lot of sense, but it probably means we're gonna see a lot more 3D printed parts in upcoming Lamborghinis. So in the new Lamborghini Huracán STO, or Super Trofeo Omologato, 3D printing innovation focuses on a 3D printed key. The Huracán STO achieves the highest level of downforce in its class with the best aero balance for any rear-wheel drive car and the delivery of a superior aerodynamic load, a key factor in its enhanced cornering performance. Overall, airflow efficiency is improved by 37%, and a significant downforce increase, 53%, is reached over the Huracán Performante. Now, yes, this is just the key that enables these aerodynamic parts to be enabled, but that's beside the point. We're gonna see a lot more coming soon, and for now, this is really a focus on mass customization of the key, which is finally being 3D printed. Kudos! By the way, if you're not already subscribed, definitely go down there and hit that big red button, because we're moving right along into the news blitz. We've got Desktop Metal finally rolling out their machine shop metal binder jetting system globally. We've been waiting for this forever, as some said it would never happen, but it's finally here, so definitely check that out. Next, we've got Technorobotics partnering with Jabil for advanced material manufacturing. We've got Node, who's advancing audio design thanks to 3D printing technologies. We've got a great article on titanium, with the 3D printing metal of the future in the medical sector, question mark. We've got Fiat Chrysler automobiles using additive manufacturing to design suspension systems. Skoltech scientists develop a novel method of 3D printing personalized ceramic bone implants. We've got the FDA clearing 3D systems patient-specific 3D printed surgical guides for ankles. In the crazy news, we've got Konami partnering with Open Bionics to launch official 3D printed Metal Gear Solid bionic arms. That's right, you too can have a bionic arm from Metal Gear Solid. We are living in the future, guys. This is awesome. Anyway, did you know that your business is gonna be featured next week? If you email us one of the cool ways you've used it in your home or your business or whatever, or your channel, and we'll feature it on the next episode. Just email us at contact@fishminder.com and put YouTube Spotlight in the subject line. Anyway, please leave a comment down below. Let us know what you thought of this episode, news stories you thought we were cool that we missed, or anything you want us to cover in the next one. And of course, we love funny comments too. Here at Vision Miner, we actually specialize in functional 3D printing, especially high performance plastics like PEEK, Ultim, PPSU, PPS, PSU, CFPA, and more. So if you're interested in that kind of thing for your business, definitely feel free to reach out. We got the tools, we got the machines, and we got the service if you want us to do it for you. Give us a call or shoot us an email. We're down here in Southern California. We love talking to you guys. Anyway, that's all I got for you today. So have a positive rest of your day, and I'll see you on the next one.